Why I'm going to be creating a mini series where I create a $1 deck for each available domain. So this is video number 2 with my $1 or actually in this case $1.5 deck. So my idea is to create a $1 deck that you guys can be building very very easily just by harvesting the daily gadget rewards that you can get by playing in the ranked ladder. So instead of trying to get the best card, we're going to be trying to get the more accessible cards and actually making a solid deck with them. Today we're going to be playing the God of War, and this is the deck that I got together. Again, the cost of the cards played a significant role here, and ultimately I think that this deck ended up being 150. And as you can imagine, we're playing an aggro deck, and we got some creatures that can be very sticky if we manage to secure the board. We have Enduring Shield to help us protect our creatures, then I have Headman's Axe to try to deal 7 damage to my opponent if we lack that little bit of final spark to close out the game. Iris's Runeblade for the same reason, if we ever make it up to 8 mana, that can help us win. So guys, let's immediately now head into the ranked ladder. My current rank is Solar Gold, so rank number 10 out of 12. And let's see how we're going to be doing today. Okay, my opponent is not going to play anything, so let me just put Enduring Shield on the board. Lysander Spear, okay. So we're going to see some weird stuff happen. The other thing about this deck is that we don't have any removals. Oh, what? Okay, so we're playing against... Oh my goodness! What are you doing, friend? Yeah, okay, that's kind of illegal, I guess. And also, the other problem that I have is that even though I can get rid of this Pyramid Warden now, we're not getting any value out of him. Oh, unless I do that, wait. Actually, I can get value. By the way, we're playing against a very strong deck, so let's see if we will actually make something happen here. I can trade here, and that's going to go down. Then I can attack with you, and we are getting my creature back. And now let me attack again onto you. And guys, somehow... Oh, this got blitz as well? Oh, I made a mistake then. Yeah, let's get rid of that regardless. I made a small mistake here, we could have made a much better play. If I kept this as a 5-1 protected creature, it would have been better. Okay, my opponent is playing a very weird but strong deck, which tells me that we're probably losing the game. I mean, I can get rid of one of those. Actually, what do we do now is the question. I can play Valkas's Foreguard. The Afterlife is actually good enough for me here. I am going to get rid of that. Then I think I'm going to play Vicious Rend to get rid of you. And then I am dealing 5 damage to my opponent. And let me try to draw a card actually on the next turn. Another very strong creature for my opponent. Okay, that is good. I mean, I can attack my opponent directly here. This will give overkill to the Archangel Bruiser. Let me attack here, and then we're going to pray a little bit. I can also just attack... Let me attack here, actually. Let's get rid of that. That's good, that's good. That's quite good for me. And then, guys, let me also just use the Rune of Sight. And I think I prefer the Blade Caster for the next turn. And that's going to be it. What is this Mystic deck that we're playing against? What the heck? Stop being weird. And the Nonic Nightblade, that's very good. Okay, now I don't think we can realistically recover the board, however. I can play you and you, probably. Just so that we play on tempo. We really need to get some value out of Auric Mage here. Okay, hopefully that's going to be enough. Oh, what? Guys, we're playing against a very, very strong deck. I am not even kidding. Ouch. Okay. Okay, what are we even playing against? I swear, this is very, very weird. Golden Genesis card? Who are you? And why am I facing you? maybe we can survive another turn after I play single combat. Let me do that onto you. Then I can attack here. And then I can get rid of you with my God Power. And then I have 2 more mana left, and what am I going to do with that? How can I make this deck at least a little better? How? Golden Asterius! Man! Let me just play my $1 deck! What are you doing? Okay, I need 1 more mana. I need a miracle. I need my opponent to disconnect. We can't win with this deck. Yep. It's kind of over. Let me just play you, let me play you. Let me concede. Let's give a thumbs up to my opponent. They had a good deck. This deck is very, very strong. Let's concede. Let's see where we stand right now. I am about to be demoted. My $1.5 deck is not doing great, but in my defense, we played against some pretty good opponents. I mean, we could have won the first game. These guys slapped me around with their wallets, just like that. But if we lose, this is probably going to be my final game with this deck, and maybe I can just come to terms with the idea that the War Domain is not good enough to have a $1 deck. Finally, I can start by playing the Bladecaster. Yay, we finally have a decent starting hand, guys. Okay, let's start with a Bladecaster immediately. If I see Light's Levi here, I'm going to be so sad. What is that? Oh, come on. That's a small problem now. How do we deal with that? We can't deal with that right now, so I'm just going to play Enduring Shield. And then I am going to actually attack my opponent directly, I think. Yep, that's going to be it. Oh, we're going to get ordered. No, that's no good. But my opponent has committed a lot onto this creature, which means that the Archangel Bruiser is going to give me some good value here, since my opponent got very greedy and didn't want to clear this. So let's punish that now. Guys, okay, so now I am going to play you, the Archangel Bruiser. I am going to attack one of those immediately. And then I am trading that for basically free. And I am very happy about that. What is that? That's another strong creature for my opponent, but what can we play now? Oh, single combat actually works great for me here. Let me do that immediately. And as soon as I do that, I can also just use the extra mana to use my god power here, guys. And I am going to do that because I really want to make sure that this creature is alive and well. And yep, then I'm just ending my turn. Finally, we're making it out of the early game with a decent board state. Oh, not Thestor. Okay, we really need to get rid of you. And honestly, we are very happy that we have the Ogre Archer here, because I can attack obviously here. And then as soon as we get the 20 favor, I am going to get Ogre Archer to get rid of you. Guys, this one, we might actually win. Heal, okay. Oh, what the heck? That's very easy for me to get rid of, and I think I'm going to do that with a Headman's Axe, or I can also just keep that and try to get... No, I'm just going to use that relic. Let's preserve my creatures. Then I am going to play the Bladecaster. And guys, we actually have a board to ourselves. It's looking great. It is actually looking great. Oh, what? Aegis of the Innocent. Ha! Huh. Okay, that is now a very strong thing that I don't want to deal with. I can probably put you on the board. Yeah, let me play the Nightleaf Trapper here, guys. First things first, I am always attacking with you. Then I can play Spoils of War. That's very good, but I still need to do that. Oh no, I messed up. Why did I even do that? That was such a troll for me. Anyway, let me play the Tartessian Blood Mage, and then I am attacking my opponent directly. I forgot how this relic works, oh my god. Anyway, let's see if my mistake is going to be enough to cost us the game or not. Heal for my opponent, that makes sense. Yep, ouch, that hurts. That was quite a mistake on my end. But, okay, it's looking a little... How much damage do I have now? Well, we don't have enough to win with Vicious Rend, so let me try to get rid of you. I'm going to play Vicious Rend onto this. I am kind of trolling today, I think you guys are seeing that, right? Then I can play the Enduring Shield, and I'm going to put one hero in training down on the board as well. And that's going to be it for our turn. Oh, come on, not certain. I can play another hero in training here, and that is going to make my life a little easier, because now I can play Valkas's Foreguard. We still don't have enough to win. Let's try to get overkill. That's going to be huge. Nope. And let's deal a bit more damage to my opponent. Guys, we have a board. And I think we might actually win a game. We played against a weak deck, but let's be honest, in the ranked ladder you're not always going to be facing decks like the ones we did. I would even say that we got a bit unlucky. We are 1 damage off lethal. If my opponent makes a recovery here, I swear I am going to be so sad. Guys, we actually won against the Olympian Light deck, and I guess that's good. We controlled the board against a decent deck. Should I have... Okay, we actually won a game. Ultimately, we ended up dropping a rank while I was trying this deck out, but it's all good because I am here for the content and I am here to educate you guys. Honestly, I think that the War Domain didn't perform great in our $1 deck challenge. I think that even though we have some cheap options, the $1 was too much of a threshold for us to actually put something good together. Let me know in the comments if you have any other card suggestions that I could have used in this deck. Even though we didn't perform great today, I am going to be trying a new domain tomorrow. We have already made a $1 deck with Deception and War, so let me know in the comments which you would want to see next. Nature, Magic, Light or Death? And before we go, don't forget to make a comment right now because we have a 100 Gads tokens giveaway this week. And every comment that you make immediately gives you an entry to the giveaway. So that's all, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all tomorrow with a brand new deck idea.